One of the more underrated teams in the NCAAW currently are the Nebraska Huskers, who, as of when recording this video, just won their 10th straight game. The young squad has been dominant through their first month of action, currently sitting at a record of 10-0, but for some reason, this dominant start isn't getting a lot of love, not just in the media, but also the AP Top 25 poll, with the Huskers rarely even being a consideration to make the top 25. To me, Nebraska is easily a top 25 team in the nation and should make the cut. So, in today's video, I'll be discussing why I believe that is the case by looking at their game so far, the players playing well, and other things contributing to their dominant first couple months of basketball. Before we start, if you're new here and enjoy the video, be sure to subscribe for more women's basketball content like this. I'm trying to reach 1,000 subscribers by the end of the year, and we are so close to that goal, so all support would be greatly appreciated. Anyway, with that being said, let's talk about the Nebraska Huskers. As I mentioned, the Cornhuskers are off to an elite start to this season, winning 10 straight matches, the first time the school has done that since the 2010 season. These aren't easy games either, as the Huskers are in one of the most competitive conferences in the NCAAW in the Big Ten. Nebraska has dominated many of their games, winning games comfortably that they should win comfortably, and consistently finding a way to get the job done against other competitive schools, like their 5-point win against Creighton and 3-point win over Minnesota. There are a couple of factors for why this is the case. One reason is the Huskers' incredible offense. Nebraska's offense is in the elite tier in the NCAAW, ranking highly in multiple offensive stat categories in not just their conference, but the entire country. Nebraska currently ranks 6th in the entire nation for field goal percentage and assists, which is just insane. Specifically to their conference, they're second in field goal percentage, only behind Ohio State, a top 20 team in the country, and they're first in assists in their conference too. The Huskers are also a top 5 team in the country in points per game, currently scoring 85 a night, and also are a top 10 three-pointing shooting team in the nation too. As of when recording, the Huskers are the only team in the entirety of Division 1 women's basketball to have recorded 10 straight wins. By the time this video is out, South Carolina may have matched that, but still, the fact the only other team that may be 10-0 in the entire country aside from Nebraska is the number one ranked team is crazy and should not be understated. Nebraska is a legit force, and the AP poll needs to realize that. But what players are contributing to the Huskers' success early on? Why have they been so dangerous through these first couple months of action? The first player we need to talk about is Jazz Shelley. The Australian guard has been the superstar for Nebraska and is leading them with her incredible scoring and playmaking abilities. I recently did a full breakdown of Jazz Shelley a couple weeks ago, so for a deeper breakdown on her game, be sure to go give that a watch. But for now, through 10 games, Shelley has led the Huskers averaging numbers of 15 points per game, just under 5 assists and 7 rebounds. Through these games and large opportunity, she showcased her biggest strength to the world, that being her scoring and shooting. As I mentioned, she's averaging near 15 points on the season, but has had multiple games scoring well above that, such as a 22-point game in the second match of the season, or a 30-point outing against Drexel. On the season, Jazz is shooting 53% from the field and 56% from three. That's just absolutely insane. And though that shooting rate will probably drop off a bit, I think it'll stay as a part of her game for the most part that makes her and the Huskers so deadly. At just 5'9", it would surprise you how big of a presence Shelley seems to have inside as well, indicating by the high number of rebounds she gets per game. Something surprising to see for a guard her size. I mean, she's had 3 games this season where she's grabbed 9 rebounds or more, and in one of those matches against Alabama A&M, she brought down 6 offensive rebounds. It's amazing stuff, and truly indicates Shelley's heart over size mentality that's made her such a prominent threat. As I said earlier, Shelley is also a fantastic playmaker, evident in her 10 assist match against NCCU, which was a match where she also got a triple-double. Shelly has the capability to influence a game in so many ways, and it's what is giving her the case to be a legitimate All-American caliber player, or at the very least, All Big Ten player this season. But even though Shelly has shone through 10 games, there's still a few other players repping the Huskers uniform that is leading them to big success. One of them is Izzy Bourne, another Husker from Australia. After making the Big Ten Honourable Mention team last season, Bourne has continued her hot form, boasting stats of 11 points and 5 rebounds per game. The forward is a strong presence inside on both ends of the floor, being a crafty finisher around the rim, as well as being strong to protect the paint, evident from her 3 blocks today against Indiana State. With this, Nebraska's offense has become diverse. Both inside and on the perimeter, there are threats, so it's clear Bourne has been a driving factor for their success. Two other players on this team that have been impressive early on are Bella Cravens and Sam Hybe. Alongside Bourne, as a forward, Cravens has been impressive, averaging 8 points and 9 rebounds per game on 62% field goal shooting. The tandem of her and Shelly in the pick and roll, as well as the pick and roll with Shelly and Bourne, has been sensational early on for the Huskers, and it's been one of their more effective plays to run on offense. Hybe, though sometimes inefficient, has been important offensively too. Just the other day, against Minnesota, she dropped 13 points and 6 assists in support to Shelly's lead, helping dictate the flow of the game as Minnesota tried to push a small run late. Hybe's best play comes on the defensive end of the floor though, and it's why she's a starter for this team. She's got great instincts there and is stealing the ball twice a game as a result. As great as an offensive team Nebraska is, sometimes they struggle defensively, but Hybe's keeping them in check, at least on the perimeter, and it's why she's developed into such a valuable player for this team. So those are all the players I want to talk about today for Nebraska. But now, how good is this team actually? How far can they go? To me right now, I think the Huskers are very capable of being a March Madness team and probably would be able to get through to the round of 32. They've got the strength, depth, and of course, the offensive weapons like Shelly to keep them competitive with other top sides. Now obviously, Nebraska is yet to play any ranked team this season, so it's probably a bit early to tell how legitimate of a squad they are, at least compared to other top 25 teams. But regardless, 10 straight wins to begin a season is mad impressive. 4 straight road wins in 10 days is also crazy, which is what they accomplished on their most recent road trip. It's especially great considering some of the hostile environments that they were playing in. However, with that said, though Nebraska has had some lack of experience against other top sides per se, the Huskers do have an extremely tough stretch during January, facing Michigan, the 12th ranked team in the country, Iowa twice, who are currently ranked 8th, and Indiana, who are currently ranked 4th, in just a span of 11 days. That's going to throw a lot of adversity the Huskers' way, but if Jazz Shelly and co. can thrive through that adversity and be competitive with these teams, I think it will show a lot about what this team is and how good they really are. Again, we're going to have to wait and see how well Nebraska truly stack up against the best of the best, but I think this 10-0 start to the season is more than enough for the AP poll to finally rank them in the top 25. I mean, there's literally other teams in the top 25 currently, like Colorado, who are also yet to play another top 25 team. To put it simply, there are not many unranked teams playing the competition level Nebraska is playing, and winning every single game. So at this point, it's kind of getting disrespectful. This is a young team. I believe only one or two players on this team is going to be forced to leave at the end of the season as they're a senior. There is simply so much potential here. Nebraska won't be going away from the top of the Big Ten for quite some time. So it's time we see the respect be put on their name and have them finally ranked in the AP poll's top 25 teams. And that will conclude the video. What do you guys think of this? How good are the Nebraska Huskers to you? Do you agree that they should be ranked as a top 25 team in the country? Let me know all your thoughts down in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to leave it a like and subscribe. But with that being said, I will see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.